Hello, hello, this is Melvin from Aromotive Diagnostics Pro. We are going to replace the power steering pump, you know, to this 2008 Ford F-150 XLT. It's not a hard part to do it. The good thing is, you have to know that there is a couple options, you know, on the auto parts. There is a couple options about the power steering pump. One option is the just the power steering pump, right? So you have to reuse the old pulley. Okay, so you can probably you can get only the power steering pump, but also you have to reuse the old one. Remove the old one is hard to take that one out, so you need special tools to do that. So if you have the tools, okay, go ahead, you know, remove the old one, put in, you know, and the new power steering pump. But there is another option. The other option is get power steering pump itself and then the power steering pump pulley, both parts, right? And then put everything together. It's a little bit easy, you know, because you have the new pump and new pulley, just to put the pulley in, right? You don't need to take it out the old one. So maybe with a bolt you can put in the new pulley. But there is the other option, the better option. Get the power steering pump assembly with the power steering pump pulley. As you can see, we have here the power steering pump and power steering pump pulley all in one assembly. Everything is in place, ready to put it on. So if that is the case, it will be easy. You don't need to remove the power steering pump pulley to remove the belt or to remove the power steering pump. So you can take it out the power steering pump with the pulley. I prefer, you know, remove the reservoir with the hose to get out the power steering pump assembly. There is a 3 10mm bolts. You have to remove it from place to get access, you know, to the pump itself and take it out. Right, but before that, you have to remove the high pressure hose, you know, which is right here in the barrel. You need a 19mm wrench to remove that hose over there. The hose is attached with a bolt to the engine, so I recommend remove that nut over there, you know, from the stud. Remove that nut because you need a free hose to take it out, because you have to protect the thread on the high pressure power steering hose fitting, right? So to get access to that one, you have to go under the car, right? You have to go under the car. Better you put your nose, you lift it up the car a little bit, right? And then you have to go under the car and remove the oil filter, the oil from the filter catch. These are 2 10mm bolt. You have to remove these 2 10mm bolts to remove this thing, because without this thing, it's better for you to see what you are doing while you are removing the high pressure hose. So without this, it's better, you know, you can see what you are doing with the 90mm wrench. So when you remove this, when you remove that thing over there, you know, the hose, the power steering high pressure hose, you can remove the lower bolt, 10mm bolt, take out that bolt over there, and then you can go to the top, remove the air filter hose, you know, the pickup hose, remove the air filter hose, and then the belt. To remove the belt, you need a half inch bar to remove the tensioner, remove the belt, and then remove the other 10mm bolts on the top. Maybe what is going to keep in place, because there is the hose, right? So it doesn't matter. After you put, you know, remove, after you put, you know, the new one, you can take it out this one and put it in place. And then this return line, you know, you have to remove this return line and 2 8mm bolts from the top of the power steering reservoir, and just loose a little bit the third bolt, which is right here. Just remove the bolt right here and then slide out. and you can take every all this out and put the new one in place. So I hope you can have a little bit information about this 5.4 liters 3B engine for F-150 replacing the power steering pump assembly. All right, good luck with your project. Have a beautiful day. See you on the next video. Bye bye.